changes his mind or is prone to telling a few porky pies.
Right here in my favourite song.
Well, he's definitely our favourite guest. Yes. It's Michael McIntyre. Yay!
Which is your favourite city?
I'm quite relatively fickle, you can probably sense that. But I'd like to say factually that you're my favourite one show presenters of them all!
That's good enough.
Bit of you. So.
That's good enough for us, Michael. Now, speaking of good results, did you see Strictly the Weekend?
Well, I haven't been watching the series, I just watched your dances.
Thank you.
And yes,
was that your favourite?
Yes, without a doubt.
Oh, of course.
My favourite artist. Arnold Jordan. Sorry, yes. My wife's waiting. Oh, my God.
We have to say, of course, congratulations to the lovely Harry Jurt for winning. There he is, lifting the crystal ball.
And lovely to see Ellie over there getting her hands on the ball as well, at long last.
And we noticed, Michael, you're quite nimble on your feet. A lot of skipping goes on in your shows.
Yeah. Well, this was in reference to a joke that I did, but not a lot of people know about the joke. They just think I do this.
Well, we think you might be quite good at
that. There's my favourite.
You have got my favourite.
It's the hands of
legs. Incredibly active. I've never seen the montage like this all put together.
Well, coming up in honour of your skipping prowess, we have the GB Senior Skipping Team here. They're down in reception.
I trained with them for the Olympics in 1976.
Will you have a go later?
I'll do anything you want me to. Yeah, I'm going for a
lot. Giving.
I am very giving at this time of year as well. Is this a real treat?
No. All right. First, it's a perennial problem for prisons. You lock up a criminal, they serve their sentence, but sooner or later, some of them are back inside again.
Simon Borsman looks at one pilot scheme that aims to reduce reoffender. I'm not very good. I'm a last minute. In fact, I say that I still haven't bought all of last year's presents for me. But I've decided this year I'm going to buy slightly less. I've decided not to buy a present for my mother-in-law. Not because every year I give her something nice, and she always goes, "Oh, you shouldn't have. You shouldn't have. Oh, you really, honestly, you shouldn't have. Oh, I don't know why. You shouldn't have." So this year I'm not going to. I'm just going to leave it. Maybe she'll go, "You should have," but you know, we'll wait and see.
And what about prezzies for you then? What's on your list? Are you kind of a tools man? Do you like tech things?
Sorry, am I a tools man?
Yeah, yeah.
See, I don't know. I said, yeah, like a drill.
Yes, man.
Do you know what I mean?
Yes, man.
Drill?
Yes, you're absolutely right. Yes, I like the drill ladder tool. Oh, that's what I've asked for. You know me so well. I'm hoping to get a ladder and a drill, just like you suggested, Matt. And I will be atop my ladder at Christmas morning, just drilling at random. I can't wait. What a wonderful day. Who do you think I am? Who have you mistaken me for?
A man.
Yeah. No.
This is the man who skips on stage. Anyway, two young sons, 6 and 3, so they're in the prime time for Father Christmas and all the rest of it. Describe Christmas in the McIntyre household.
People do this all the time. They always ask you about how's Christmas. You know, all day people are saying to me, "What are you doing for Christmas? What are you doing for Christmas? What's happening this Christmas?" It's the one day of the year we all do exactly the same thing. It's like, I'm doing what you're doing. It's much like at your house.
You'll be up early.
Yeah. Well, last year, this is actually true. My children woke up at 11:48 on Christmas Eve. They came running into the room and went, "It's Christmas!" And I was like, "No, it's 11:48. It's not Christmas for 12 minutes." And they went, "Well, wait!" I was like, "No, we can't start Christmas Day on the first second of Christmas." Now, of course, I'm up early. I'm up at the crack of dawn, as you do with the children, and they're so excited they don't even register what they're getting. They just rip it open and next one. It's like, "Why don't you play with this?" And I spend most of the morning trying to open the battery compartment of all the toys, and then hoping that I get the cracker that has the miniature toolkit.
There you go, you see?
My favourite present. Yes, I can do the batteries now, darling. And then I eat until I announce that I can no longer eat anything else. I do this every year, I will never, ever eat again. And then half an hour later, I go, "I'm going to have a sandwich." That happens almost every year.
But the more you eat, the more you want. I mean, that's what they say, anyway.
Certainly at Christmas, it's amazing how much the capacity we have for eating at this time of year. Have you started? Have you started to eat too much?
You had a mince pie, actually.
Yeah, I started today.
Yeah.
There was a lot of puff pastry going on earlier. Anyway.
The Christmas Comedy Roadshow special. It's on at 10:30 p.m. on Christmas Day.
I had a show on Christmas Day, which you might have come to.
I was there on Tuesday. Brilliant night, by the way. Very funny.
I thought it was, I have my road show, which has been for two series on BBC One, but it's a Christmas special, and I've worked for months and months and months to make it as special and as different as possible. And we have an incredible lineup. Honestly, it's the best show I've ever been in. Really? I can't believe how good it was. We had so many people that I got. Look, there's all the people who are in it. You know, James Corden, Miranda Hart, Rob Brydon as Father Christmas, David Mitchell does a monologue from the Royal Box, Jack D, first time doing stand-up in years, Sean Lock was hilarious, Rod Gilbert, it must have been, how funny was Rod Gilbert that night? Absolutely sensational.
Yeah.
And then also some crazy moments. I sung Fairy Tale of New York with Pixie Lott, which...
We didn't expect that, Michael.
I didn't do space either.
Yeah. Shall we have a look at him in action?
Okay.
Here we are.
I love him getting my tree. Because it's Christmas Day, and, you know, it's 10:30 at night, and I know the state of the nation. We've just tried to make the most entertaining Christmassy. I mean, it's so Christmassy, ending with Kylie singing Let It Snow with all the comedians, and just tried to make it as funny as possible. And it couldn't have come out better.
No, it's absolutely superb. It's nearly like a variety show, nearly. I mean, the only bit I felt uncomfortable was when Rob Brydon came on. And then he went, oh, the lovely Alex is in the audience, and started sliding down the chair. And then he went, oh, yeah, the one show where you've got all these weird gear changes.
Yeah, that's true.
And he said, as long as you put the word lovely in the middle, everything sort of goes together, which is what I do.
I thought you actually even introduced yourself as lovely. Alex Shaw's there. Shall we do one of them gear changes now?
Yeah, we will. Okay, we're on to Christmas carols. There we are. That was quite slick.
That wasn't much of a gear change. We could have saved that for presents.
Now, what happens in the McIntyre house when Christmas carols come to the door? Do you offer mince pies, or do you make everybody hide, turn the lights off, pretend there's nobody home?
Oh, well, I would think turning the lights on at that stage after they've rung the doorbell is going to be ineffective. Because they're going to see those lights going off, which is going to be awkward. Yeah. But I do get scared when people come to the door, is that wrong? But carolers are lovely. Well, you're lovely, it's lovely. In Wales, everyone must go caroling, because Welsh people love singing more than anyone I've ever met.
Yeah, there's a lot of carols.
Is there anyone in? They must all be caroling instead of sort of a million tall people. In fact, I would have thought just the doorbell sets the Welsh off. Ding dong, melody on high.
Well, one tune that the Welsh and everybody can't do without, of course, is Hark the Herald Angels Sing, what Charles Brandreth has discovered. It started out a little bit differently.
270 years ago, Bristol was the cradle of the Methodist movement. Radical sermons preached the most popular carols in the world. What do you think Charles Wesley would have made of that?
I think in one way he'd be very surprised. Another way, he would be thrilled to bits that the whole world were singing the profound words that he had written.
Saying, you do feel the need to applaud at the end of a carol, but yes, silent as it would be.
Yeah, it's not practical.
Do you have a favourite Christmas song?
I like all carols. I don't think there's a carol I don't like, because you know they're so Christmassy and you hear them once a year. But I do like that the Fairy Tale of New York, like I mentioned. That's why I sing it on my show.
Yeah, that's a good
one. I do think that's
we
a good
one. We don't know the words, but we like
no.
it.
No, stay tuned. Christmas night, 10:30.
Right, we are now going to play a game, Michael.
It's all about Christmas songs. Okay, so what we're going to do is we're going to show you some pictures.
Oh, I thought we were going to play a proper game, like Trivial Pursuit or something.
Well, do we have time for that?
Do you want to have any other ideas?
Okay. Looking back at that film, this is Hark the Herald, Bishop. Herald Angels Sing.
Yeah, but the X has been crossed out, so it's a hark.
Okay. Hark the Herald. Okay, Angels Sing. All right.
Here we go. We've got three for you.
That's Harold.
We can play Trivial Pursuit.
Okay, very good. All right. Well, we got that one.
Right, this is your first one. Okay. Yes. So, here we go. Who's that?
Holly Eyepiece.
No.
No. Holly.
Holly Willoughby.
Yeah, but Holly.
Holly.
Think of a song.
Holly in the Eye. Yay!
Holly in the Eye. This is it. This one. Okay. Here we go. Straight on to the next one.
Excellent.
This is a bit difficult.
Yeah. Yes. play along at home, by the way.
Come on, David. Xavier Frost. Oh, Frost.
Frosty
the Snowman.
Yay! And the last one, here we are.
Oh, I know this one. Man boobs. what's the next one?
Okay, chest.
Chest. Chestnuts roasting on the open fire. Well, I think with a bit of help, you did manage to get through. So you've got yourself a pair of Christmas.
Oh, they're fantastic.
Socks.
What was that? You said you left out the word socks like that was part of the quiz. I know what socks are.
Christmas socks. Oh, yeah, they are. I thought they were clubbies.
Okay, thank you very much.
They'll keep you.
Yay.
Now then, one thing we like to do on the One Show is reunite people with the heroes who rescued them in their time of need.
Yes, tonight is the turn of the Glenister family. In the world of power skipping.
Hello, girls.
Yeah. Yes. Okay, now we've got Becky, Gemma and Laura with us, who are record holders, aren't you, in skipping?
Yeah.
And you are going to show Michael what he needs to achieve before the end of the One Show this evening. Yes. Yeah?
Give us an idea of the world record you have.
Our world record is the most consecutive jumps done by three people in double dutch.
Wow, which is?
368. And double dutch is the way you two people, one person each end, turn the ropes, and it's three people jumping all at the same time.
Right, piece of cake, Michael, piece of cake. Let's have a look. Can we stand back a little bit?
Here we go.
That was excellent. That was well done, girls.
You ready? You're going to leave your jacket on? Are you going to leave your jacket on?
Yeah, no, that's fine.
Okay.
Right. Are you serious?
Eh?
What do you want me to do?
We'll just have a little go.
Okay. No.
What do you mean a little go?
Gemma will explain to you how to do it.
Gemma.
You've got Christmas tree needles in your hair.
All right. That's best if I put it
there. Okay, so what you're going to do is you're going to watch the rope closest to you. Okay. When it hits the ground.
What do you mean the rope closest to me?
Well, this one here. Exactly this one here.
All right.
So when that hits the ground, you're going to say go and you're going to follow it. So it'll be ready, set. Go, follow it in, and start jumping.
Oh. All right.
Okay.
Right,
that
but
looks...
what if I don't like it?
You'll be fine, you're just...
and both of these girls are Dutch, is that right?
No, English. So,
come on,
ready?
Here we go.
Set. Ready?
Oh, I'm going to go. All right.
So, ready, set, go.
Go, he's in!
Super Christmas Day with your comedy roadshow. Thanks ever so much.
Thank you so much.
Thank you so much. And we'll see you tomorrow with Andrew Marcy with Sam.
That was absolutely great.